18 years old. Should I need a hair transplant? Hi everybody. I'm 18 and going to university next year, and I really don't want to start as bald. I'm really in a bad situation. I really don't want to go outside before night because of the sun. I lost my self-confidence. Please give me some advice.
Thank you for your question. You're 18 years old and you've submitted multiple photos that clearly show a very aggressive pattern of hair loss. I understand very well your despair and how you've lost confidence and you're going out at night because you don't want to show the light of how much hair you've lost, and it's completely understandable. Unfortunately, male pattern hair loss can begin as early as 18. So, assuming that you've already had all the medical reasons for hair loss ruled out, and that this is something called male pattern hair loss, you're asking about transplantation. Well, hair transplantation is generally ill-advised for someone as young as you who has such an aggressive hair loss pattern. And I'll explain why, and then I'll discuss a little bit about a technology that we've developed called hair regeneration that I think would be worth considering for you. When you're losing hair as rapidly as you are, you have to also understand that there is an expectation with hair transplantation to fill the area to a level that would mimic as if you never had hair loss. And unfortunately, that's never possible. Hair transplantation is the use of a limited number of what we call genetically resistant hairs to fill strategically areas on the scalp where there is hair loss. Now, if you were somebody in your 30s, 40s, or 50s, then the conversation would be very different because the expectation and understanding of the degree of hair loss that is in the norm, it allows us to transplant hair in a way that would, let's say, frame your face. But when you're young, there's a general rule of decades. When you're in your 20s, only 20% of men have hair loss. That means 80% of men have really, really good hair at that time. So transplantation can't give you that full volume that so many of your contemporaries have right now and will have for the rest of their 20s at least. So the options that you have to consider first are medical options. And when I talk about medical options, I talk about basically two drugs. One is minoxidil and the other is finasteride. Minoxidil is a topical application. In my clinical experience, minoxidil doesn't really make much of a difference for younger men like yourself who are losing hair so quickly. And the other drug is finasteride. Now, finasteride is a pill. It's a tablet. It's a 1 milligram tablet you take once a day. And it's based on the understanding that a certain group of men have male pattern hair loss based on, at least in part, on the androgen sensitivity of hair follicles to dihydrotestosterone, or DHT. And what finasteride does is it inhibits an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase, which converts testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Unfortunately, in my clinical experience, people who are losing hair at this young age, the 18 and early 20s, tend not to respond very well to finasteride. So we have been able to help a lot of people with something that we've developed over the past couple of years called hair regeneration. Now, this is based on the serendipitous discovery of a wound healing material called extracellular matrix and its remarkable ability to actually thicken thinning hair. So what we've done over the past couple of years is developed a combination of this extracellular matrix and platelet-rich plasma, your own blood, which is spun down, and the platelets, or the healing cells, combined with the plasma in your blood, which has growth factors and other things that are good for healing. And we've been able to perform these injections. Now, this is different than a transplant. This is just an injection or a series of injections at one time. What we have observed is a significant improvement in the progression of thinning. In fact, there's a reversal of thinning and a thickening of those thinning hairs. What we've observed is that the more recently thinning hairs respond very, very well, and the older or longer thinning, in terms of time, hairs that have been thinning for a long time respond, but respond not as well. So timing is very important. So what we've been able to do is literally change the conversation about what to do about male pattern and female pattern hair loss. So if you were to come to our practice, or someone like yourself would come to our practice, I would just recommend hair regeneration from the get-go. Your option of considering using the topical minoxidil and the finasteride are still worthwhile considering. There's a lot of concern about the sexual side effects of finasteride. So most of our younger patients, and being defined as people in their 20s and 30s, do not want to take finasteride. But it's still something that it's worth considering. You should I would consider hair regeneration from the get-go to at least thicken up your existing thinning hair. In our clinical experience, this injection has helped people for 3 to 5 years. We have not had any significant trends of needing to repeat injections. We periodically repeat an injection as we develop our formulation and work on even enhancing the results that we've already gotten. But I think that this is a great opportunity for someone young like you to at least save your existing hair and thicken up what you have. So as you do your research and learn more, don't go straight to transplantation. It's not likely that most ethical hair transplant doctors would perform a transplant on you, but there's always bound to be someone who may think that they're helping you by trying to do an aggressive series of transplantations, which I'm afraid are not likely to look very natural in terms of how you look relative to your contemporaries. So again, consider hair regeneration as you learn more about your hair loss treatment options. I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.